Hello guys, I just got back from watching Kingdom of the Planet of the Apes, directed by Wes Ball, and in this movie, it takes place 300 years later after War for the Planet of the Apes, and after the Matt Reeves trilogy, which I have reviewed and made a video of. If you want to check it out, here it is. But this movie is directed by Wes Ball. And seven generations in the future following Caesar's reigns, apes are now the dominant species and live harmoniously while humans have been reduced to living in the shadows. And by that, basically the humans are the animals now. And I really like this movie. This movie was really good. I think saying really good is kind of an understatement. This movie was top notch. The movie's main character is named Noah, and Noah's nothing like Caesar. Noah's kind of not as confident. He has some like problems, but where he ends up at the end of the movie is really good, and builds up his character to be more of a leader, which I'm sure we're getting to that. This is going to be his arc, becoming a leader. And William H. Macy, which plays Frank and Shameless, he plays Trevathan, and I thought he was good too. There's a lot of actors in this movie that do a really good job, like Kevin Durant too. He plays Proximus Caesar, and he did a really good job as the villain. I thought he was really menacing. Every time he would appear on screen, he would steal the show. I do wish there was more of him. Oh, I think I have my mic upside down. I wish there was more of him in the movie, but the scenes that he is and his like ever looming presence is really good, and the CGI in this movie is amazing, top notch. I don't know if it's better than War for the Planet of the Apes, but I think it's definitely on the same boat. They're like right next to each other, but the visuals in this movie are really, really good. Like the faces that the monkeys make, like they look more human sometimes than monkeys, which I promise that's a good thing. Like you can tell like their emotions are there. And May is played by Freya Allen, and I don't have a lot to say about her character. Like she's kind of like the key to everything when they start learning about the human past and how apes at one point were where the humans are right now. But the way that the history was taught with the humans and the apes was really intriguing. How they thought that somehow they were always in power, which it can be understandable after the seven generations, you know, like history rewrites and gets like mixed up. And I do like Caesar's legacy in this movie. I do like how there's mentions of Caesar. Not a lot, but his presence is there with the window of Will. The window that Caesar would look at from inside Will's house. And how that eventually became kind of like a religious logo was really good. Anyways, this movie, it's just really good. I like where the build-up leads to at the end. The first half of the movie is like kind of slow because it's building the world and the characters. I mean, because keep in mind this is 300 years after War for the Planet of the Apes. So there's been a lot of like new innovations and new lore to the apes. But I think this movie is solid. This movie is easily 4.5 out of 5 stars. I think the movie's that good. But The movie's magnificent and impressive, worthy follow-up to the last trilogy with emotions and a really compelling story. And I just wanted to make a quick video on this movie. I don't know if I'll do an analysis of this movie, but I'm really excited for the future movies of the Planet of the Apes, because it has recently been confirmed that they're planning to do 5 more movies. So I'm sure eventually we'll get to the point where the 60s Planet of the Apes were, where they were more domesticated and wearing clothes, you know, like humans. And I'm sure we'll get to that. I'm kind of unsure if we'll touch time travel or not, because, you know, I don't want to say it'd be out of left field, because again, this is a world where apes took over humans over a drug and are now the dominant species centuries later. So I do think the time travel could fit in there somewhere. But other than that, this movie is solid, and I hope the next 5 movies they plan on doing are really good. I don't know how they're gonna do it, because 9 movies in total just seems like a lot, but I mean, hey, I have faith in them. I have faith in Westball. And yeah, if you like this review, subscribe for more. Like, for more, any support is appreciated. Yeah, we'll get on to it next time. See ya.